spellbook video. Looks like we just took a random ultimate, since we took a little bit longer to load into this one. So we'll see how it all turns out. Let's see. Wanna go for, if it's Camille, I wanna go for healing, I think. I have no idea. We'll just go for double longsword. Do that, actually. Well, it'll just be for no reason. Well, people play police because we're the bully Darius. So let's do that. No worries, no worries, no worries. But yeah, welcome back to some more spellbook, ultimate spellbook that is. As you can see, I'm probably having a lot of fun with it as of late. So, a little bit of a rip it from my throat there. But yeah, I want to keep trying to play it. I want to see what kind of combos I can get. Looks like I got Ring Girl with Darius. So out of all the ultimates, I'd probably take that. Out of most, honestly speaking. Let's get that trade off. Alright, we'll do that. I'll just run away so he can't do the true damage. He always technically win that because he, what's it called? We'll always win that because he opted to not take Torrent Shield for my poison. And if he goes Sheen against me, he can't be taking those long trades against me. We're on an island, double Torrent's Blade, so that's kind of why you go double Torrent's Blade, because you want that early lead. Want to assert yourself over them. Mainly why we win it, and basically just taking advantage of the fact that Darius is one of those lane bullies. So as of late, since Stridebreaker got a bit of a mobility nerf, I've noticed that a lot of people want to see what your take on Darius. Diana there using her whole team. And honestly, it's probably Trinity Force for the mobility. But I want to try to Divine Sunder for the armor pen you get, and then you can go Black Cleaver with that for Darius. And then you can max his E for the extra magic pen. So tons of magic pen with Darius, and you can just do that. Have a good time. Okay, just make sure we walk away from that. Okay, sorry, I guess. Do this. Just want to make sure we use our Q with our W or our Q with our E, because it makes it very easy to hit. Do that, do that, do that. Put our bots here. Should be good to go. Interesting. Interesting, interesting, interesting. Grab this. Alright. Grab that, grab that, grab that. Grab this. Alright, nice. Yeah, it's almost impossible to miss if you use your Q right after your E. Since it basically puts them in that little stun slash knockup. That slash knockup animation. Well, right after the E. So you can basically buffer your Q and the E and just land it every time. That's kind of what that's for, I think. Alright. Nice, just gonna get that trade off there. Nice. Alright, we're just gonna take this out. Nice. We're just gonna get that off. Flash away so he can't get his passive to like try to guard from our passive. He wanted to get his AD shield there. So I just wanted to flash away so he couldn't get the shield, so my passive could just kill him. Just because I didn't want to risk it, right? I just had to kill. Wanted to secure it. Let's get this here. He has an MTP. He's gonna be up soon, but I need to leave since he has his E. But even though he has his E, I want this blading. Oh, I'm gonna die. Alright. Oh, he's level 4, I'm fine. Let's just get out of here before, what's her face? Camille. Camille, I think it is, yes. Why would I say I think it is? No, because Camille will probably think, I think will kill us. Most likely, even though we could, try to just get greedy there. Let's try to take this. That'll be fine. Run back. One, my boots want that. And now I am 900 gold away from Divine Sunder. So Divine Sunder will give me good healing, good damage, more armor pen on legendary items on top of my E Black Cleaver armor pen. So I might not need to build what's it called? Can we get this? Interesting. We're just gonna get that. Pretty easy, actually. Pretty easy to just chill out there. Get all of these. Get all of these, secure that, and we're good to go. Let's get this. Since he used his E, I'm gonna go in, because he just used his E. Since he used his E, I want to try to take advantage of that, right? He used his Zoe ult, and then his E in the middle of it. So for that reason, I'm going to try to bully him with my Ranger ulti, since I'm Darius. Just use that damage, so really we can't do a whole lot there other than that. Little bit odd, want to be a little bit quiet there, just because of that, I didn't want to mess it up. But yeah, basically we're just taking advantage of the fact that Darius does a lot of damage, but in this lane phase I wanna not let Camille get any leeway, basically. That's all I want. I'm just taking advantage of the fact that I have a leap with my Alright, that's my bad. We need to go. We're so lucky that he doesn't have level 6. We're so lucky he doesn't have level 6. Alright, interesting. Alright, we're good, I guess. Alright, we're good, I guess. Yeah, I don't know. We're lucky he doesn't have level 6, though. I messed that up 20 times over. Yeah, honestly, it's fine, though. As I was saying, though, being Darius, being a mobile as Darius is, it helps to have that Rengar ulti, Rengar leap, to just get onto targets quicker. Shred their armor by 12, apparently. I didn't notice that for 4 seconds. And, yeah, it gets us a lot of other stuff. Move speed, Rengar leap, all that good stuff. Let's grab all these minions and take them over here. We do have our Sunder, so we do have that healing. Looks like Camille's gonna be mid lane. Won't be able to contest my my side split push now. I don't think, at least. I think I will be big enough to just take down this tower. Max E second for that armor pen. Make sure we have that. Now we'll just work towards let's say it's along ADAD. Yeah, we'll go Ninja Tap as well. We'll work towards Black Cleaver. Should be good. Let's get that for our Sunder proc. Grab this, keep resetting, pop both our bots just in case. Even if they come try to kill us, most of them will just die to us. We have enough healing to sort of deny most targets, at least. Yeah, for the most part, in my opinion. Okay, my bad, I guess. I guess I'll just run for now. Don't really want to risk that, right? Not really worth to risk that. Oh, looks like Katarina's gonna pick that up without me. Does not look like she will be needing me. Put that down there. I'm gonna wait for Viego to come here. Oh, just wait. Using his KL ult. Popping off with a Terminator bot while he's these guys look like they're finishing up this Batal fight. They should, bit of a rip it, but they should do the Rift Herald while we won that fight on the top side. Should be good. Chat is so crazy big, I don't know why. Oh no, no, that's crazy. Oh no, that's fine. Oh, and chat skill seems to be crazy. That's funny. Alright, we're good to go. Oh wait, she can die. I just realized she can die. What? Alright. Oh, what? That's so lame. Lux is so lame. Oh well. Look at that. Style Punch plus Flash. Oh well. Kinda lame, but I guess. I feel like Samira used that to. I don't know if she knew it was gonna mess me up, but at least now Lux dies. Appreciate it for more wake. Maybe I can assist. Nope. But yeah, that's kinda lame. Oh well. I guess I went for the dive. I'll go back top and just farm all those scams and go from there. But yeah, looks like our team is winning. That's all good. Alright. I was just wondering, I'm like, my chat seems so huge. For no reason. Seems interesting. Seems interesting. What do you want from me, man? Yeah, she's just gonna get out of there. She seems to be out of there. Go up here. I seem to be ignoring a lot of the farm as well. So I'll try not to do that. So that it doesn't affect me too hard. But for the most part, I have really good wave clear, so I shouldn't even have to stick around for the farm too much and then just go to a skirmish. All I basically have to do is just queue the wave like that and W that, and then I get most of the wave. If I am pushing, it's a different story, but for the most part it's pretty easy. Pretty easy to just kind of push it out and leave. I should head towards that even though my team looks like they'll just win it. Alright, looks like they might just win it, but I'll head over. Start heading down. Looks like an ally has been slain. Another ally has been slain. That's really sucky. Warwick's being a trooper. Okay. Wow, they're being troopers. Appreciate them. Alright. Nice. Just wanted to do that. Let's go up here. Alright. Warwick smells that she's also who. I kinda wanna go for her and see what's up. Can pop that. I want to take his red if I less damage, or unless we really need to take it from her. I think I might have just ignored Viego a little bit too much, maybe. Maybe it's Diana. I don't know if Diana's doing that damage. I'm so confused. Who do I put this anathemas on, guys? Maybe. Let's think about it. So I could put it on, let's say Viego and lowers damage, but she's the most fed technically. Let's just put it on Viego. Oh, listen. So sad. Oh well, I guess we're going around. Alright, laters, I guess. Alright, well, my team's now here. I wonder if I stole it long enough. Well, that's a good stall, I guess. I hope it's a good stall. Okay, two shuts down, two. Okay, but they got the Baron, but hey, my team can win the fight. Alright, that's, okay, Warwick's winning that fight. Okay, an ally has been slain, which is not good, but I think she's gonna die. Nice, Warwick can smell Diana. Warwick can, we need to mark this on Viego now that he'll have items. I think, yeah, he's level 14, see? Now he's level 14, just like Diana. I'd rather worry more or less about Viego's damage than Diana's damage, honestly. So let's do that. Either way, we can get a spare visage for Diana, and we'll put this on Viego, since we are a really effective tank now. Spare visage for Diana, this for Viego, and be good to go wherever Viego shows up. We will look for him there to put this on him, because it's a global. Oh, there it is. Guess we have to put this on Viego. Viego, please. Oh, I saw him. Okay, well, she's just dead. Interesting. This is good. I really want a small vehicle to put my anathemas on him. Where is he, man? Where is the vehicle? I'm so confused. Oh, there he is. But, cool. There he is. Interesting. Sad, they're just staying really, really grouped. I think I have to split. If they're just gonna stay super grouped and just wait for them to what's it called? And just wait for them to mess up here. Even though my split's kinda weak against them, since a lot of them have gotten really strong compared to how strong I was. Obviously, a lot of grouping makes me weak at a certain point because I stopped farming as much. But that's trade-offs here and there. So yeah, Grim going for the kill on Viego bot. Let's go over here, hopefully we can still just queue that. And just do our damage there. Alright, looks like it doesn't matter, because Viego won't challenge her split push. Diana will do her thing. Do this here. Let's grab that, I think in a 1v1 scenario. Yeah, I think in a 1v1 scenario, we are still technically stronger. But we need to get to that point. That's why we want to split. That's mainly why I want to split, because of, I want to get to that 1v1 scenario. Let's do this here. Derek seems so crazy to ignore just that value alone. Just the value of Derek alone seems crazy to ignore. Yeah, I don't know. We'll get on out of here, though. We'll get on out of there. I'll just get on out of there. That's fine. We'll just do this here. Yeah, they just don't want. Oh, that's so sad. Oh, that's so sad. Oh, that's so sad. Everyone just wants to flash. Of course, white people lame, but oh well. Gotta try sometime. Gotta try sometime. Oh man, oh well. Let's pick up our spirit visage. They're probably gonna go for the Baron, most likely. Most likely. Oh well. We messed up there because we could have just backed off the split bush and kept being annoying. But we didn't, sadly, so now we messed up a little bit. But our ring royalty is very in sync with our respawn almost. So that is fine. I want to get the Sterix, but I also want to get more armor pen. Seems like a lot of conflictions. Alright, Ezreal and Katarina going in. Alright, Warwick seems like he wants to try their respectable. Alright, respectable. Alright, interesting, respectable. Alright, my bad, I guess. Yeah, I guess they're just better at the game than us. Oh, this will give me a chance to try a different build, maybe the core drinker one. I was thinking, because obviously, or I could do the training force one. We never know. I mean, we obviously did fall super behind, but that happens. This always, I love ultimate spellbook because it leaves us always enough time to just hop into a game, do it really quick, 2 seconds. We'll be right back. All right. We're right into this game too. And unlike the first game, let's see what ulti we take. Gragas, Lissandra, and Momo. I'm feeling the, should I do Gragas or should we do Momo? I'm feeling the Momo. Let's do a Momo. So, unlike the first game, I think we will be doing, Core Drinker over the, Divine Thunder, and then after Core Drinker, we'll do Dread Black Cleaver again. And then Geralta's Grudge. Maybe, probably, I don't know. It seems like that's a good build for even if the other are no tanks. We'll just have 35% from this eventually because of the scaling. 30% from this, 30% from Geralta's. And we'll just basically be healing. Be healing for true damage, obviously, because this will be also dealing that 100% physical damage. So that means that the healing from that will end up being very well, good, very high, as well as the healing from Q and the healing from other stuff. Keep all of that in mind while we hear my brother, or if you do hear my brother in the background going off in Warzone. So hold on, let me mute really quick for that. 2 seconds before this lane phase. 2 seconds. All right, we're good, no worries. Just do the 2 seconds before this lane phase start off. So against a lane like Rumble that doesn't have much mobility, we're just gonna walk up WQ and do that. He actually did it, chose not to take flash. So we're just gonna do that. So he actually opted to take TP instead of flash. Which is interesting in my opinion. What did he take? Yone ulti over a regular ulti. So he should TP back here, I'm pretty sure. Oh, he's not even up yet, right? Okay, so we'll try to take these minions as soon as possible. Alright, we'll just take this last one. He didn't get his TP off on the minions, which is very nice for us. I didn't want him to TP to the minions. Now that's very huge for us. Let's pick up double. Actually, we can bully him with a pickaxe. I was gonna say double ruby crystal, but since it's a rumble with no flash, I'm gonna be looking to bully him with no, with my flash and my Momo ulti, basically. All we're gonna look at doing. Yeah, basically, honestly. the more I think about it, it's just a basic. I keep saying basically, but yeah. He doesn't have any mobility, no flash, means I just get to chill here. He doesn't get to do anything. Without saying, basically, that is all we are gonna do. Just chill out, tell our core drinker our items, and wait for that. Really nice that we took advantage of the early game where he didn't have flash. He only ulti has one of those ultis where he has to use it offensively to go in if he wants to get damage on me, and in this scenario, he can't really go in on me, can he? Alright, we're just gonna flash on him. Just do that. Alright. We're just gonna flash on him there. And yeah, he can't do anything. Cannot do anything to us. So that's pretty funny. I'll just proc those off. Get this. Make sure we auto each one, then we Q. Last hit all of those. Secure that up, but that's basically. I keep using the B word, but that's all that happens since we have already stated many times. No mobility on Rumble means we get to use our flash, our Mumwall, to just bully him with our damage since we basically have a lot of damage by ourselves. We just need to sort of stay on top of him. So we have lack of mobility, so if he has lack of mobility as well, there is no problem with our lack of mobility. Looks like they will send up Gorky though. They didn't want they didn't want Rumble getting too behind. So they will send up Gorky. I'm gonna look at this plus this. Should be fine. That's such an interesting voice for Darius to have. It will actually be super easy for me to lane against him. And I can just wave clear this, and I can just wave clear this with my Iron Spike Whip, and do the jungle really effectively with my Q healing. Since I heal off the minions with my Q now, I can just do that, and I can just do here, walk back to lane so I don't miss too much of this XP. Don't miss any of this XP actually. Perfect. So that's pretty good. I'm gonna keep the wave here, just because I want. Actually, since it just showed up. We can crash it and make a push back to us and then take some of the enemy's jungle that way. So let's take advantage of us getting level 6. Go bully the enemy jungler who is Poppy. See how that goes since it's going to be their lanes. Should be fine. I don't really want to worry too much about my lane since I can't really do too much about Gorky for the most part. So I'm just going to focus on getting enemy jungle camps. Yeah, basically getting those enemy jungle camps. Get that, yeah. Alright, basically. Alright, we'll just get that. Alright, nice. 666, securing those up. Alright. We're just gonna back out here. Oh, he's gonna flash for us, sadly. I didn't want to stay on top of him, but maybe it would have been good to stay on top of him. I think he would have gotten away from us with his flash regardless. Now he uses his flash to get back on us, and hopefully Diana can nope. I was gonna say, hopefully Diana can pick him up. Ooh, that was actually really smart flash. He can't really get out. That way we're gonna miss all this farm, which hurts me, but the whole point of me going over there was to bully the Poppy. Which ended up being a success, so I can't say I'm mad. Always. Okay, Dev wants to take my farm. Sad day sometimes. When the jungler just takes your farm, but we got tons of levels and gold regardless from killing Poppy and Rumble, so we can't really complain at all there. Got our full mythic item now. We're basically unkillable with this mythic here, and now we're gonna get our damage. And build towards our tank after that. We're basically gonna just keep walking into our jungle like that though. We're gonna wanna keep doing that, keep pulling them, keep pushing my lead forward with by getting enemy jungle if TF is not securing enemy jungle. I can't really do a whole lot. I'm just gonna go take Crux. Cannot do anything against Gorky. Just outscale him basically. Get to the point where he can't really do anything to you. He has to just basically ignore you, or let you do whatever you want, or fight you, which he can't do because you're Darius. So no point letting him poke us, letting him worry us in the late phase right now. just gonna do this here. Grab up. Get back to lane. Oh, missed that. Oh, actually, for some reason, that was in the range. So that's good. Now that we grab the Crux, it makes it really easy. was definitely dead in that situation if it wasn't for Diana. So I very much appreciate it. Let's grow over here. Please die, Rome. Thank you. Grab these ones. Grab this. Looks like we might be able to get blue. So we might be able to do that. Yeah, it looks like we can. Let's grab this. Get this. Alright. Yeah, Bobby's gonna head up here soon, but it'll all be gone. It'll all be gone. Nope, she's gonna head towards Drag. Her bot side's gone. Her top side's gone. She's gonna be very sad, but we have a lot of gold to spend and just basically, yeah, go crazy with here. 2k gold off 2000. You can go sell some items and get Geraldas maybe. 3000. No. We would have gotten it. I have the gold, but that will be this video for Darius, making it a little bit shorter. Thank you all so much for watching. I do hope you enjoyed. Now make sure I see you very, very soon.